that goes as far as giving his father a kidney to keep him alive.
Yes.
Does nothing but godliness there.
Amen.
So you don't need, no need to worry about that. Yes, I'm James Norman. So much for the title, but anyway, I've been on Cedric for 34 years. Met him in 1990. I just finished school and I was working for this big time evangelist, and he had a unique voice. And I was controlling the sound system, something like this. Where is it? Something like that, but it was a whole lot bigger. I mean, huge, had a lot of knobs on there. And this evangelist wanted his voice to sound thunderous, you know, heavy. And I could not work miracles. And I would try to work on that sound system, and you know, he's preaching before 2,000 people, and I'm trying my best to make sure his voice sounds picture perfect. And I was messing up, and Brother Cedric just dropped by nicely. He said, "You may want to turn up the highs and or turn down the highs and increase the lows." And I did that, and the evangelist said, "Perfect, Norman, keep it there, keep it there." I looked at Cedric, I said, "Listen, man, I don't know you, but you make sure you come back tomorrow." And every night, Cedric showed up in the background, helping me work the sound system. And then later on, we went by his house. I'll just stay by, talk to his dad, his mom, and we'll just have a good time. And after I got picked up, I was hired by the conference, became a pastor, small church. But Cedric would come down and he'll make my church look like a mega church. He said, "Now Norman, you know, people visit the website before they visit your church." And so Brother Cedric, he will, I may have just a few members, but on the website you'll see a big choir singing. And he had a TV station on there, a radio station, and people just showing up in there at my church. And I just praise God for Brother Cedric. He's such a kind man. In fact, let me say this right here. Some of my churches, they can afford a website. But don't you know Cedric spent his own money supplying a website for my little churches? And I tell you, even though we don't talk every day, but whenever we do talk, it's just like we just pick up from last night. And I just praise God for Cedric. He knows my wife, my entire family. In fact, let me tell you this one story that's pretty funny. While I was working the sound system, Cedric would say, "Norman, you know, this lady over here, she likes you, and that lady over there, she likes you as well." I said, "Now, Cedric, I'm engaged." He said, "Well, man, at least put a picture on the sound system so people can know who you belong to." I did just that. And then Cedric turned around and said, "Man, don't you know that man put a picture on the sound system and everything, making fun of me?" But pretty soon, my wife came by, you know, she's from overseas, and she came by, and Cedric met her. And just a few months ago, we came by and we visited a church, and one of the young ladies that liked me, Cedric was there, and I introduced my wife to the lady, and Cedric, he was just trying to hold his composure. And Cedric didn't say a word, praise the Lord for that. And he called me later on and said, "No, man, I didn't say a word, I didn't say a word, I didn't say a word." I said, "Praise God for you, Cedric. I will forever remember you for that." But my dear friends, Cedric is such a giving person. He's such a kind person. And I consider myself fortunate and blessed to have a dear friend such as Brother Cedric. And Brother Cedric, I just want to let you know that I love you. your true friend. And man, I just praise God that you're there not only for me, but for my entire family. We love you, man.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate those kind words. Now, need to find someone who has some mischief that my friend did back in the day. Family member, when he stayed in trouble all the time. But he didn't get any trouble. Cedric has this wonderful line of, as my mother would say, line of child, about marital. he's got marital advice. And every time he starts that, I start looking at him and say, no. No, anybody but you. So we have Bill call me on the phone and he'll get on that roll and Cedric, no. Cedric, help the bear, don't help me. The bear needs help. Sister Law?
Yeah.
Oh, we got some.
My cousin is telling me we need to get somebody to pray over the food so the food can go ahead and eat while we do it.
That would take care of it, but I'm sure we got.
Well, if that's the case, well, let's go out and see. You know, it's still the
same. But I need to say something.
What you say?
You might not know who I am, but I'm B. Parks.
She's the lady over this whole thing. She did a great job.
Yeah. We got this up because Cedric, me and this one here, it's usually not a day pass or not. 2 or 3 days a week, the three of us, we talking. That's just how we always been. It's 13, was 13 in my mother's family. And we all know all of our 13. We knew all of our 13 aunts. We knew all of our uncles. And we knew their kids. And we just always been like that. And then Cedric, not too long ago, Cedric said, I never had a birthday party. Me and Linda said, what? You've had a birthday party. And so me and Linda said, well, you know what? We're going to give you a birthday party. Because his mother used to always say, give me my roses while I'm living. I said, we're going to give you your roses while I'm living. Because Cedric, like you said, is a giving person. He don't know how to say no. And me and my brother over there, he was, I don't know how to come up, he said, now his dad and Cedric is just like, he said, you know who's my favorite uncle? I said, you don't have to, you can tell me, I said, Ezell. And his, probably what, 4 or 5 inches, no, Ezell is an uncle by marriage. And Ezell helped, his daddy helped probably every niece on his wife's side that he didn't do something for. Like, personally myself, I never bought a wash and dryer. And when my uncle died, that's the first time I had to buy a wash and dryer. And I said, oh, I got to buy a wash and dryer. He was just like that. And I was in school, he fixed my tire, he'd go come and get me. He was just, and this one, he's the same way. He's just a giving person, and we love him. And Ezell was like, oh, we miss him. And his mother, they was just two of the kind. They couldn't have been two perfect people. So everybody have fun and eat, and we want Cedric to enjoy this day because we love him, and we want to show him, now you need to get your flowers because he's been good to everybody.
Mr. Dan Clemens, Reverend Dan Clemens, preacher. Let's church say amen.
Amen.
Let's church say amen.
Amen.
I won't say anything about you, Sheriff. I'm going to keep all our stuff a secret. If I tell it, it won't be good if people go home with their head thinking different about you than what I've already heard. Anyway, I'm asking us to let us bless the food, if you don't mind. Let us all, dear God, we just thank you for this day. We give thanks for all that you've done and all that you continue to do in our lives. God, you're so awesome, and we praise you, and we lift you up right now. Now, God, we ask you to bless this food for the nourishment of our bodies. Bless those that are not as fortunate as we are, Lord, dear God. We ask you to bless the ones that prepare this food. God, we just thank you so much. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Cedric, you want to be the first one to come up and eat? Come on. Come on now. Come on. We will come back and your seat as quickly as possible so we can finish the program.
Me and Faye grew up together, and it's nothing like, you know, I was on the channel, but we always had somebody living with us. You can name, and that's one thing my parents did. When somebody got in trouble, when those sisters got, it was 13 of them, but when somebody couldn't take care of the child, the other sister stepped in and we kept Juanita. When our mother died, she stayed with us. She stayed, I mean, you can name her. We all were just like brothers and sisters. And there's so many people here that have been a part of. Christine had a book out that she wrote. When she went through 12 years of, I don't know if it's 12 years, but so many years of school, 19 years of school, and never learned how to read and write. She never learned how to read and write. She got a job at Shoney's, and they fired her because, you know, she memorized the people who were taking over. And gave it back to the waiter, the person who was taking, you know, the person who was cooking and stuff. But this lady is fascinating. And and y'all read her book. You need to read it. Couldn't read or write and went to Metro School. And there's so many people here of just my life. And I think I've been crying for the last 3 days because I didn't think anybody cared about it. I didn't think people would come to this thing. They talk about it in January. And I just started 2 weeks ago getting involved. Because nobody's coming to my birthday party. Nobody's going to be here. What's the purpose of this thing? And I kept saying, what's the purpose of having a birthday? Nobody's going to come back and say, I should have came, but I'm sorry. I didn't want to make it. And that's what I expected. And when people started calling me up and writing me, it was like, I don't believe it. And I couldn't do but cry. I'm sorry. I thank you all for coming tonight. I thank my cousins B, Atrius, and Linda Lamb for putting this together for me because I never would have did it. Never would have done that. So thank everybody for coming, and I appreciate you. Thank Mr. Head. Together, her and Linda right here.